Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the mayor, the police commissioner, and the entire New York City Police Department, we welcome you to our street naming ceremony honoring Detective Wenjen Liu. At this time, would everyone please rise for the presentation of our colors and the singing of our national anthem by police officer Lauren Leggio.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight? O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave? O'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you, Lauren. Thank you, Officer Leggio. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for our invocation by New York City Police Department Deputy Chief Chaplain, Monsignor Robert J. Romano.
Let us pray. We come together today, Father, to do what we as the New York City Police Department does very well, and that is to come to remember. As we gather here today to remember Detective Wenjen Liu, we also remember his partner, Detective Rafael Ramos, and all those who have been taken from us in our department. We ask your mercy upon them and to give them the gift of eternal life. As we gather here today with Wenjen's family, we ask you to give them the consolation that they need, that they might be able to get on with their lives, pick up the pieces, but always remember and know that they are loved by every member of this department. As we gather here today, we pray for all the members of our department that they might be safe on and off duty. As we gather here today in freedom, we cherish that freedom because it is won for us every single day by the men and women of our armed forces who serve us so proudly, many of whom are members of the NYPD. Watch over them and bring them home soon. And finally, Lord, bless all of us as we come together today to remember that this day might be a day that will live forever in our hearts and in our minds. And we place this prayer now in your name. Amen.
Thank you, Monsignor Romano. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. It's indeed my pleasure to introduce members of the dais assembled with us this morning. I would ask that you please hold your applause until all have been introduced. Seated in the first row and on my right, the Chief of Transportation Bureau, Thomas Chan, Chief of Transit Bureau, Joseph Fox, the Police Commissioner of the City of New York, the Honorable William J. Bratton, the Mayor of the City of New York, the Honorable Bill de Blasio, New York City Speaker, the Honorable Melissa Mark Veverito, the Borough President of Brooklyn, the Honorable Eric Adams, Assembly Member for the 47th Assembly District, William Colton, seated in our second row, Patrolmen's Benevolent Association President, Patrick Lynch, Detectives Endowment Association Vice President Paul DiGiacomo, the Commanding Officer Patrol Borough Brooklyn South, Assistant Chief Stephen Powers, Police Department Deputy Chief Chaplain Monsignor Robert J. Romano, Deputy Commissioner for Administration Kathy Perez, United States Marshal Southern District of New York Michael Greco, City Council Member District 47 Mark Traeger, seated in our third row, the chairman and CEO of the Tunnels to Tower Foundation, Frank Seller, New York State Senator, the Honorable Marty Golden, and the commanding officer, Patrol Borough Brooklyn North, Assistant Chief Jeffrey Madry. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our day. We thank you for being here. It's indeed my honor to introduce the mayor of the City of New York, the Honorable Bill de Blasio.
Sir. Thank you so much, Lieutenant Giorgio. We gather together today to honor a good man, a very good man, a man who we should all hope to emulate in all we do. Detective Wen Jianlu epitomized sacrifice, courage, concern for others. And that example will now be remembered in yet another way, and we will ensure that his name and legacy is passed on to future generations in many ways, one of which will be the naming of this street today. West 6th Street between Avenue S and Avenue T will be known going forward as Detective Wen Jianlu Wei. And for the Liu family, for their neighbors, their friends, the entire community, this will be one physical manifestation of the life of a great man, one more reminder of his brave spirit. I want to thank Commissioner Bratton and all of the members of the NYPD leadership who are here today. I want to thank the family of Detective Liu, of course, his father, Wei Tong Liu, his mother, Shouyan Li, who we have all had the honor of getting to know their strength, their dignity, his wife, Pei Xia Chen, who has spoken with such eloquence about the meaning of her husband's life. And I want to thank all of the Liu family members and all the Ramos family members as well who are here. The two families have been in such great solidarity with each other, and we honor that. And I also want to thank Captain Sergio Senta and all of the officers with us today from the 8-4 precinct. I want to thank Pat Lynch, President of the PBA, and all other labor leaders with us today, and my colleagues in public office, Speaker Mark Viverito, Borough President Adams, Senator Golden, Assemblymember Colton, and Councilmember Traeger. And I particularly want to thank the Speaker and the Councilmember for the work the City Council did to ensure this renaming would occur and would occur promptly. We thank you. It's powerful to be remembered in the place that was yours. And this was Detective Liu's place. This is where he first experienced New York City and the United States of America. This is where the American dream came true for him, and it did come true. Came here, he had to learn English. He got an education. He followed his dreams, and he did it with such tremendous poise and talent, and that's why he kept finding each door opening for him, because he was the kind of person who was worthy. And not just worthy in terms of education or in terms of his achievements on the job, worthy because of his commitment to his family. We've heard the stories, but it's so important to reflect on them. We all wish for children who would think about their parents every day. That was Detective Liu. In fact, one of his proudest moments was right near here where he bought a house for his parents, knowing it would secure them as they continued in their lives, that they would have the security of a house that he, product of the American dream, was able to buy for them. That is not only a compassionate son, but a son who always tried to do right, and he always tried to do right by his wife as well. He was the kind of man who took so much from helping others. That was true on the job, that was true with his family, that was true in his neighborhood. He gave everything to others, and he gave everything to all of us serving in the line of duty. This city, this nation, now knows of his life. We were heartbroken together. We were heartbroken for the loss of Detective Ramos together. But we learned about two great men, two men who are, to so many of us, an example of what we aspire to for this whole society. The NYPD, as always, has been a true extended family. Those words are not just words when it comes to the NYPD. It's a truth. It's a reality. They stand by the families of those who served, and those families will always know the embrace of the NYPD. Last month, our nation honored Detective Liu and Detective Ramos, a law signed by President Obama creating a national alert system to warn officers of any threats to their lives. These men didn't die in vain for so many reasons, because they did so much good and they touched so many lives positively. And now, even though they are no longer with us here physically, their spirit lives on, and they have touched the lives of our entire nation with a law that has been passed and named for them. On Tuesday, both men received the Medal of Honor, NYPD's highest award for courageous sacrifice. I'll conclude by noting this was not just a brave man and a strong man, but a profoundly warm and compassionate man. He cared so deeply for his family. There was a love that ran through all he did, and his love for his wife was so clear. And she has said, since his loss, something very simple and something so obviously true as you get to know her. She said of Detective Liu, "He is my heart." And he remains close in everything she does. In fact, she wears his badge every day. That connects us to a powerful sentiment once expressed by the great thinker Confucius, who said, "Wherever you go, go with all your heart." The Liu family continues to go with all their heart, and their heart includes Detective Liu, and the heart of all New Yorkers does as well. Thank you.
And thank you, Mr. Mayor. It's now my pride and pleasure to introduce the Police Commissioner of the City of New York, the Honorable William J. Bratton.
Mr. Mayor, the mayor thanked all who assembled here today, our political leadership, our union leadership, men and women of the department, particularly Detective Liu's co-workers at the 8-4, family and friends, and I echo those sentiments. Very special day, a very special morning, a beautiful New York morning, breeze blowing in the air. Monsignor Amato, in his remarks, talked about today as a day of remembrance. The mayor talked about the idea that we are here to honor. But the action that we are going to undertake here together this morning is to ensure that we never forget. We have memorialized Detectives Ramos and Liu in our Hall of Heroes, more recently on the wall, the Memorial Wall in Washington. Today, we will continue that memorialization with the renaming of this street, this intersection. Next Saturday, on the six-month anniversary of their tragic deaths, we will do the same for Detective Ramos. The story of Detective Liu is an American story. It's an immigrant story. It's a New York story. But more than anything, it's a Brooklyn story. As this is where he first came, at 12 years of age, where he lived, where he grew to love the country, his new adopted home, and where, as he grew to love that country through the experiences here in Brooklyn, he understood that what he wanted to do with his life was in the Chinese tradition, take care of his parents first and foremost, take care of his new wife, certainly. But also he wanted to give back. And from his earliest times, he continued to give back to Brooklyn, because Brooklyn had given so much to him. An auxiliary police officer where he first experienced the NYPD and all that we do for this city. And encouraged by that experience, he fulfilled the dream, a dream that so many of us have that are so privileged to wear the blue and the badge of the NYPD. The dream to become a New York cop, a Brooklyn cop. Served briefly in a precinct, but found his home in the 8-4 precinct. Found his home in the assignment that he so often had at the Brooklyn Bridge, the symbol of this borough, the symbol of this city, the symbol of uniting. And in his death, and the death of his partner, they brought about a uniting in this city at a time of great turmoil in our country, at a time when we were being driven apart. The horrific circumstances of his sacrifice and that of Detective Ramos helped to start bringing us together once again, to connect us like the bridge, to connect us like Brooklyn connects people from all over the world. From all over the world, they come here to fulfill their dream, to raise their children. And as we go forward, we will continue to remember, certainly. We will always honor, and we will never forget. And one of the ways we will do that is through this street sign that we are about to unveil. Because in future years, as young mothers with their children cross this intersection to take them to school, as people go back and forth to work, they'll look up at that street sign. And I can imagine young children standing there waiting for the light to change, looking up, saying, "Mommy or Daddy, who was that?" And I hope that they're able to say, "He was a hero. He was a man of Brooklyn. He was a man of New York. He was an American. He died for us." And so we will never forget, because it will always be there to remind us of his sacrifice, of his love for family, love of department, love of city, love of country. Wen Jin Liu, a Brooklyn man through and through. All the best.
And thank you, Commissioner Bratton. At this time, I'll ask the mayor and the police commissioner to join the family at the sign for our unveiling. Would everyone please rise? Would everyone please be seated? It's now my pleasure to introduce Detective Liu's father, Wayne Tang, and wife, Sani.
大家好，今日是六日十三号，美国政府正式命名 S 及 T 以后西六街为刘文健的大道，这是政府 NAPT 经贸处长市长给我的仔的给予我的仔的最高的名字，你用你的生命捍卫捍卫这所城市，保卫了所有的民众，你敬恩你一台刘文健，你是我的骄傲，你民运活在美国华人世界人民的点长，你的真善的素德你万岁不了，对这般难而来，我的家人压够你们的东乡副东乡赵江徐江跟某队长 NYPD 各局长为我的关怀和关心，还有布鲁顿社区各社区各局所桥梁朋友邻居天热的关怀的无畏无，我的灵魂为我的神灵的冠冠，而且我问待我的呢所有帮国我安然我安然满，同时呢多多多多国美天文他要听了他们家我的对的改名的建筑，我就是说这个说呢你先在建行出于盘论更多顺利，同时呢阿伯我的八十里分局的吉根乱文一直以来呢无微不至陪伴还有照顾我一家人，有过了对干夫的热度，而且我哋啊，几十几款嘅，六十几款嘅嗰个跟人玩，都系换话嘅干点系咪维护？换对下啦，诶，咪俾啲换话嘅干照维护，我哋啊，我哋啊，
I'm going to do a translation for my father-in-law. Today is a very special day, June 13. Thank you all for being here to celebrate Detective Wen Jianlu, right next to our home here on MUT and West 6th Street. It is an honor to have this corner name after my son. My son chose to be a New York City police officer. He sacrificed his life for this country and his job to protect this city and community. He gave everything to this city. I am extremely proud of my son. He will always be remembered. Within these 6 months, I sincerely thank those who visit us at our home, Vice President Joe Biden, Governor Cuomo, Mayor de Blasio, former Mayor Giuliani, members of the NYPD, politicians, organizations, friends, neighbors, families, and many more. We are so touched by their love and support. Special thanks to the NYPD, members of the 84th Precinct, the 62nd Precinct, Detective Su Tu, for their dedication to our family. Thank you all for being here today and thought of our family. Thank you. But right now, I want to make my own little speech. Good morning. Mayor de Blasio, Commissioner Breton, and all the honorable distinguished guests here today. Thank you for taking your time off in sharing this special day with our family. This celebration will just last a few hours, but your generosity, love, and support will be a lifetime remember of how grateful for all who touched our family's lives. I want to thank the City Council who approved the bill, Mayor who signed the bill for this street renaming. I also want to thank our New York City Police Commissioner, William Breton, for his great leadership and hard work. With his great leadership, I believe and know the community will have the trust and faith in the New York City Police Department. We as an individual and community have to recognize our law enforcement officers. Law enforcement officers play a big role in our community. We need them to protect and make our city a better place to live, play, and work. Our law enforcement officers sacrifice their lives day in and day out in serving and protecting this great city. This city is our home. From the bottom of our family's heart, we want to thank the New York City Police Department for everything they did for our family. Commissioner Breton, I personally want to thank and recognize a very special police officer who made a huge difference in our lives and everyone she touched. Her name is Detective Su Tu from Community Affairs Division. She has demonstrated and showed our family what the New York City Police Department is all about. Officers in uniform truly care. Officers care about the community, people they protect and serve. Because of her, Detective Tu showed our family and those we met and greeted the true value of the New York's finest. She is an amazing officer. Again, Commissioner Breton, thank you. And all the members of New York City Police Department, may God bless you, Commissioner. The New York City Police Department, everyone here today, and may God bless America. Thank you.
Just have a presentation from the 84th Precinct. Would everyone please remain standing for our benediction by Police Department Chaplain, Deputy Chief, Monsignor Robert J. Romano.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as you see today, the wounds have not healed, nor will they ever heal, but we learn to live with them. As we gather here today, may this street sign be an everlasting memorial to the life, to the dedication of Detective Wenjen Liu. May all who see this sign know the story of this great American hero. And as we gather here today, Lord, we ask your blessing upon his family, that they might receive that consolation that they need. May God bless the Liu family. May God bless the NYPD. And as always, may God bless the United States of America. Amen.
Thank you, Monsignor Romano. Ladies and gentlemen, as we conclude our ceremony, please join us as we present God Bless America, which will be led by Police Officer Lauren Leggio.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam. God bless America, my home sweet home. God bless America, my home sweet home.
Thank you, Officer Leggio. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our street unveiling ceremony. On behalf of the mayor, the police commissioner, the leadership of our city council, we thank everyone for attending. Have a pleasant day and a safe trip home. Thank you.